contact tracing is one of the best tools we have right now.
And did you go to work on Monday?
Until we get a vaccine or other type of intervention to stop the spread. I'm Emily Gurley, and I'm an infectious disease epidemiologist at the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health. When the pandemic first started here in the United States, we took a very aggressive measure of asking people to stay home. So we have to move to strategies that are more targeted and that we can live with for a longer period of time because this pandemic isn't going to be over anytime soon. Contact tracing is a process of steps whereby we identify people who are infected. We help them change their behavior, isolate themselves from others so the virus doesn't have the chance to infect more people. And then we ask them about their contacts. And then we find those people and we ask them to change their behavior in case they were infected so that they don't go on to infect anyone else. I'm the lead instructor for a course on contact tracing for the pandemic.
You can see the six steps of case investigation and contact tracing.
I worked with a dedicated team at the School of Public Health to put together the course. Ultimately, contact tracers are disease detectives, therapists, and social workers. You have to be good at talking to people.
Right now, there's a possibility that they could have coronavirus.
You have to be a good listener. You have to be empathetic.
We strongly recommend that you quarantine yourself.
As soon as the course became available, very quickly, enrollments went up and interest was very high. We've had over 400,000 people enrolled as of today.
What is contact tracing and how does it work?
The media is vitally important in this pandemic. More people will hear about the work we're doing through the media than will ever read our scientific papers.
What's the training to be a contact tracer and what roles do they play?
This really is the way that we communicate with people, and everyone has to be in communication about the pandemic.
Good evening, Emily Gurley.
If we're gonna have a chance at slowing it down. I hope we learn that lesson and we recognize how important public health is to our collective well-being and that our fates are linked. And I hope the investments that we're making in public health now continue and are sustained because that's going to be our best defense against the next pandemic, and there will be one. The School of Public Health can play an important role in educating the next generation of public health officials, of epidemiologists, that are going to be dealing with the next generation's pandemic.